see the lunches of working adults. We start off today in an industrial area near Tokyo. This is the cafeteria of a plant in Yokohama. We take a look around and see that most people are eating delivery bento. Bento includes 7 dishes, including grilled chicken and fried fish. Employees here get to eat this for 250 yen. What a deal! This plant is the only one in Japan that manufactures a certain product. Can you tell what it is? Vinyl records! Did you know that production of records is on the rise worldwide? Their busy days are back! Lunchtime for the vinyl record makers! Last year, a vinyl record shop was opened in Shibuya, Tokyo. It garnered attention as a record shop run by a major convenience store company. In this day and age, where listening to digitized music is such an easy process, some choose to savor music by listening to vinyl records. Others enjoy the large covers. This record player, which converts vinyl records into digital files, is so popular, there's a long line of people waiting to get their hands on it. And who are the people supporting this recent vinyl boom? Engraving the grooves. A process called cutting is the most important step in making a vinyl record. Mr. Tezuka is a cutting engineer with 40 years of experience. On this day, his job is to make a vinyl record version of a jazz recording from 40 years ago. Production of reissues like this is on the rise. First, Mr. Tezuka listens to the original tape and adjusts the tone. He will then engrave the grooves onto a smooth disc called lacquer. A cutting stylus made from stones such as ruby and sapphire is used. All the music will be transferred into a groove only 0.05 millimeters wide. The spaces between grooves are different among records. Determining the appropriate space comes down to the engineer's experience and technique.
The duration of recorded material differs from piece to piece. A classical piece may be over half an hour, whereas some of the hip-hop music may be under 10 minutes. But the area on which grooves can be made is the same. This one will have about 11 grooves within a millimeter. For a half-hour piece, there'll be the need to fit 15, 16 grooves in a millimeter.
If the gap between grooves is too small, the needle will skip. The gap must also be adjusted to achieve the desired tone. Various pieces of music are all made to fit within a diameter of 30 centimeters. That is the skill demanded of a cutting engineer. We asked Mr. Tezuka what the unique allure of the vinyl record is.
There are many advantages to digitized music, so it's difficult to explain why analog records are regaining popularity. And old records have noise and are scratched, but there's something comforting about them.
Mr. Tezuka does not say that the analog record is superior to digitized music. He's a legendary figure in the industry, as it is said that most Japanese people have heard something he worked on. Mr. Tezuka cut the record of a major hit children's song that has become a classic in Japan. After the cutting process is completed, the master plate is made. The master plate is then used to press polyvinyl chloride into records. In the age of digital formats, vinyl records were said to go extinct. But they're still around and regaining new life. Allured by the vinyl record, Shinsuke Nishiya traded his old job for one here 7 years ago. For a long time, Mr. Tezuka had been the only cutting engineer at this company. Mr. Nishiya was hired to inherit his skills. Mr. Nishiya is a musician himself. He met Mr. Tezuka when he was trying to make a vinyl version of his music and eventually decided to work under him. On this day, he is cutting a record for a band that has just made its debut. Digitized music is superior in sound quality. Yet many musicians and record companies are increasingly ordering to turn pieces into vinyl records.
1日... I cut more than 5 pieces a day. So obviously, I work overtime quite a lot. The idea is to make a digital recording and then make a faithful vinyl version of that. I think it has the potential to become something new.
To turn modern digitized music into vinyl records is a new way of appreciating music. Okay, it's finally lunchtime. As there is no kitchen in the plant, most employees order the delivery bento. This is Mr. Tezuka's lunch on this day. As Mr. Tezuka is single, he says he really appreciates the delivery bento available at the cafeteria. Oh, it looks like Mr. Nishiya has homemade bento. Mr. Nishiya, too, is single, but he packs his own bento every day. Oh, he's a bento man. It seems he does this for a reason.
I used to eat the delivery bento, too, until about 2 years ago, when I had some liver problems. And I've always liked cooking. My recent favorite is shiri shiri, stir-fried carrots and eggs. I think it's an Okinawan dish.
It's called shiri shiri.
Yes, all you do is stir-fry carrots, put a little flavoring in, and then you add some eggs. It's so simple, but a great way to eat a lot of carrots.
Despite their different bentos, the master and his pupil eat together every day. But I'm sure Mr. Nishiya has to take some very harsh words from his master.
Have you ever been yelled at?
Surprisingly, no. Mr. Tezuka always tells me when I do something wrong. But he hasn't yelled at me.
You have to make mistakes if you are to learn. Since we have a lot of work coming in, I'm sure he'll make mistakes. And I think that's a good thing.
Some skills can only be achieved through making mistakes. The recent boom in vinyl records allows for Mr. Tezuka's skills to be passed on. Streets and interview people who have just finished eating lunch.
What's your first task of the afternoon?
Preparing documents for a presentation.
Oh, I see. May we film you doing that?
Huh?
Well,
that would be difficult. There'd be a security issue.
We know it's a lot to ask, but we want to find out what that energy stored at lunch is used for. The number of lunches equals the number of first thing in the afternoon. So let us see. Your first task of the afternoon. To Today, we're in Yotsuya, Tokyo.
Excuse me. What did you have for lunch?
Ginger sauteed pork.
It was a lunch meal?
Yes.
What was it like?
It comes with an all-you-can-eat buffet of side dishes.
A buffet?
Yes.
Do you go often?
Well, sometimes, yes. It's healthy food.
I see. So what's the first task of the afternoon?
I run a honko seal shop.
Really?
Yes.
This is the ginger sautéed pork meal the honko seal shop owner had at a tavern that is open for lunch. He mentioned he loves the side dishes. I see there are many kinds. Every day, 7 side dishes are prepared for the buffet. I see how that'd be fitting for someone who is conscious of their health.
We were hoping we could film you doing your first task of the afternoon.
Well, I do not mind.
Really?
Yes.
May we follow you?
Yes.
Yes! Thank you, sir! This is Yukio Mochizuki. It's his style to walk to the local shopping street a minute away for lunch with a newspaper under his arm like that. Yes, he looks very local. Oh, is this your shop, sir?
These folks want to film us.
This is Miss Nakamura. She's a part-time worker. This shop has been here for 109 years. Plus, it is situated right in front of the JR Yotsuya station.
My grandfather came out here as a merchant from Yamanashi. He built a shop. It's here today.
So you are the third generation.
But there's no fourth generation. That's why I've got to get married this year. I don't have anyone yet, but I must marry.
You can do it, sir! The shop takes custom orders to make anything that has to do with names. Registered seals for individuals and corporations, rubber stamps, business cards, to nameplates. Ah, a customer. It's his first task of the afternoon.
I need a seal.
Thank you.
Companies announce transfers in March or in April, the beginning of the fiscal year. The shop receives 30% of all orders in a year during these 2 months. Most order notes are handwritten, so Mr. Mochizuki double-checks everything.
Does this character include that line?
Where?
There's a version with a line here.
Oh, no, without that line.
That's quite a rare kanji character.
The things I sell represent my customers.
Uh-huh.
It's somebody's name. And with it, various contracts are made.
This bicycle is Mr. Mochizuki's partner. In the morning, he rode it to an area over a kilometer away to deliver 130 rubber stamps.
Their office used to be around here. But they moved. Still, they give us the order, so I ride my bike and deliver. I think the farthest customers are about 10 kilometers away. Many customers move elsewhere, but continue to give us orders. I'm thankful for that.
There was a time when the shop employed 30 seal crafters. Today, all crafting is outsourced. Rubber stamps are designed on the computer, and the data thereof sent to a manufacturer. The job has become high-tech, but Mr. Mochizuki's lifestyle has not. He doesn't own a cell phone. His information source is the newspaper he reads during lunch. And that info comes in handy when he talks to his near 100 regular clients. The healthy lunch he eats supports his life of seals, newspapers, and his bicycle.
I want to keep working as long as I can, and I want to stay healthy. I want to travel, and I want to ride my bike. And I want to get married.
Ah, marriage again!
If I want to get married at 50, I'd better at least be healthy. I really want a family.
Ah, so healthy lunch is a manifestation of his sincere wish for good health. Hey, single ladies, there's an earnest, healthy man in Yotsuya. Let's hear the lunch stories from all of you out there on Everybody's Lunch On! Maru-chan from Hyogo writes, "My darling, who cooks at an Indian cuisine restaurant, makes me bento every day. That's wonderful." Until 3 years ago, she used to eat out for lunch. But when her boyfriend saw that the results of her medical checkup weren't so great, he began making bento for her. You've got to admire how he uses so many colors. Every day, the healthy bento includes brown rice, stewed vegetables, beans, and pickled items. Her colleagues envy her bentos, but she lies and says she makes them herself. When asked about how she cooks something, she just fakes it. But she feels guilty about it, and that's why she sent this in. Perhaps the truth should be told in person, not over broadcast. Rika and Kumamoto writes, "After 24 years of marriage, my husband has begun taking bento to work. My husband is a banker, and it had been usual for him to go out for lunch with colleagues. Worried about her husband's health, Rika had offered to make bento for him many times, but every time, he'd just say no. Even when her husband was having stomach problems, he'd just decline, saying no. However, 3 months ago, out of the blue, he said, 'Maybe I'll start taking bento.' Rika asked why, but her husband didn't answer. She still does not know why he decided to do so, but she's just happy to be making bento for him. But are you sure you don't need to find out why? I'm pretty certain that something happened to change his mind." The next delicious message comes from Tsukuba City, Ibaraki Prefecture. Asame Kakefuda, who works at a hospital as a nurse, writes, "Sometimes my boss, the head nurse, brings us rice balls when we finish our night shifts. That's great! The rice balls are energy-boosting, mysterious, and full of playfulness. What kind of rice balls could they be? Rice balls? We'd better investigate. This is where Miss Kakefuda works. This community hospital is big enough to house 400 patients. This is Asami Kakefuda. Tell us about that energy-boosting, playful rice ball."
For example, at New Year's, she wrote the character meaning the year of the goat. "This is my favorite. I thought it was a monster in Japanese folklore, but she tried to illustrate a girl."
Aha! They certainly are playful. It's the head nurse's style to serve rice balls with a twist. And she hands these out right after people get off the night shift.
She says, "Well done," as she gives these to us. So I really feel like, yes, I've done my job.
And the giver of the magical rice balls is Toshiko Onose, the head nurse. "Ma'am, that's a little big, no?"
"I don't want to leave any rice left over."
These huge rice balls will be given to the three staff working the night shift. It seems she cooks bento for herself, but what? A plate? Not a bento box?
"I'll put rice and dishes here, wrap it up, and take it. I like eating as I do at home. Plus, all I have to wash is this one plate."
She even looked for a bag that is perfect for this plate. Now this is lunch on a plate. We've seen someone else do that before on this show. I guess there are some people who do this. She came up with this idea as she found it too much of a hassle to wash a bento box. And then she thought, why not make rice balls for the staff while I'm at it? That was 3 years ago. She doesn't want it to be a chore, so she makes it when she feels like it, about once a week.
Good morning, everyone.
In the morning, Miss Onose has a meeting with the nurses on the day shift. With over 20 years of experience as head nurse, she leads about 80 nurses working in the outpatient department.
I'd come in the morning and see the staff in the emergency room being very busy almost every day. As I cook myself bento, I thought, why not make rice balls for the three staff on night shift? In time, I began thinking about what kind of rice balls would be fun. And so I started making different kinds.
This is the emergency room. It's almost 9 in the morning, and the night shift staff are about to finish their shift. It isn't rare for them to treat seriously injured emergency patients throughout the night. Miss Kakefuda says she attended to 40 patients in this one shift.
Well done.
Staff work the night shift once or twice a week. So if a staff's night shift just so happens to be on the day the head nurse feels like making rice balls, bingo!
Miss Onase, good morning. Well done. You've got some? Yes. Rice balls. Good job. It's big. Eat and see. Thank you. You two finish up. Good job.
These two have also just finished their night shift. Well done.
It's her first time.
Miss Kobayashi, who has been working in the emergency room for a year, gets Miss Onose's onigiri for the first time. A nice homemade rice ball right after being tired out from working all night? Yes, I can see how that would make anyone happy.
I'm guessing there's something in the center. See? An omelette.
Oh, I see. A wiener.
Right. Her rice balls are not just large. Her playful twist this time is the ingredients inside.
It's like a full bento.
At lunchtime, Miss Onose eats together with her colleagues. There it is, lunch on a plate. Amazing, all the dishes are just the way they were mounted. This is Miss Onose, the head nurse's lunch on a plate. As she doesn't have much time in the morning, she stocks up on dishes when she can. She always assorts the plate with sautéed and stewed veggie dishes. The pickles, too, are those she made herself. On a table full of bento boxes is a lunch plate. Unique. What did everyone think when they first saw this?
The lunch plate? I stared at it and thought, wow. I'd like to try it, but it seems like a challenge. You only need to wash one plate. It'd be hard to bring this without having things flip over.
Again, like every other day, Miss Onose cleans her plate.
It was delicious, yes.
Lunch on a plate puts a smile on everyone's faces and gets